I'm Eric Sambisa, I'm the director of Nyasa Rainbow Alliance. So Nyasa Rainbow Alliance is an LGBTI-led organization. Its membership is also LGBT and people that support and uphold the human rights of LGBTI. It was formed in 2014. So at that time, it was formed as a movement.
I was motivated to join NRA. I wouldn't say join, maybe co-found. by then, because I was still in school by then. So we actually didn't actually know the most of the organizations that were fighting for the human rights of the LGBTI people in the country, because there was that lack of information.
By then we had problems like to access healthcare. Even the legal environment in Malawi was very hostile, so the LGBT persons in Malawi were having problems even to when they were just being arrested by police without proper offense.
What we are focusing most now is decrime. Okay, so the message that we're trying to give to the people is to try to capacitate them so that they should actually know what their rights are.
There's been a debate that LGBT persons in Malawi don't exist, so we wanted to give evidence that LGBT people are there, and this is not the alien community, it's a community that exists.
The biggest problem that we have as well is the issue of visibility, because yes, we hear that a lot of trans people, right? And we have come across some, but the most that come out are the same people. Most of them are still in hiding, right? So it is actually hard to reach out to the trans people than to reach out to MSM or the other orientations.
You can't be safe out there. Yeah, I've received a lot of threats from people wanting to rape me simply because I'm lesbian and everything. Yeah. So when I heard about Nyasa community, Nyasa Rainbow Alliance, it made me feel safe. Yeah, that actually someone, when things like that happen, they actually fight for us. If something bad happens, yeah, they take action.
This organization is like a safe space for the LGBTI community. The community comes to the office to conduct different activities, like what religious activities are usually conducted at the space. Sometimes we also have like mental health topics. We did a safe house project in 2016. It was actually the first safe house to ever exist in Malawi. We also did a baseline survey for male sex workers. There is no data in Malawi for male sex workers, especially the LGBT male sex workers. But when we were doing the survey, we included even the heterosexual sex workers, because this community is invisible and we do not know their challenges.
Well, what we normally do is peer education, whereby we met a couple of people who are in the community, and then we just sensitivity on certain issues, especially health and human rights in particular.
There was a time when the authorities, like the ministers, and were coming in public to say, let's kill the gays, they don't deserve the right to life. And there was this information when people said, this is not a Malawian behavior, it's an alien behavior. So there was no one who came visible to say that I'm gay or I represent LGBT community. So I came out through the national television and I said, we exist, and killing us won't solve the problem, because we are here to stay and we're not going anywhere. We're born in Malawi and this is our home.
I was actually more motivated by what Eric did when he came out to the nation. Then I said, fine, so why should I hide? I want more people to be strong, right? To try to encourage them that we can always survive in this hostile environment.
Here on the ground, we don't have role models, people like Eric, who they've got their life going on, and they're doing something for a greater change. And for them to be openly, publicly say, you know what, we're gay, it's really encouraging for me. And it actually made me drew much attention to becoming an activist, to learn more, to become more, to do more about it. So it was really, really inspiring. I'm a student studying catering and hotel management, a diploma. I'm a model and I'm an actor as well. And I'm proud to be gay, especially in Malawi. Eric, who's a good friend of mine, actually introduced me, told me about this whole idea of the organization, and I was really, really interested in it, and then that's when I got involved with NYASA.
Just because of that interview, I got arrested, and I was pardoned by the officer in charge of the police station that I was detained to, so they released us, but I received verbal abuse. And not only that, just because of my coming out story, people came to my house and they vandalized my house, and I had nowhere to go except that I went in hiding to my friends. They kept me for some time until when the dust settled. So yeah, being an LGBT activist in Malawi is really you are always under attack.
Later on, I started working with NYASA. I worked as an office assistant, yeah. And after 3 months, something came up and I had to stop, yeah, from home.
We have had several attacks, but then we didn't expect that maybe it would go beyond attacking the office. Yeah, so the first one was a minor one. That was last year, somewhere in May, okay? Then the other one, that's when it happened in June 2018. Yeah, so they invaded the offices, they stole some files, okay, which had information for some of our members, the projects that we do. They also took some computers and stuff, right? And I was also attacked. Yeah, there's almost the same as the subsequent month. Yeah, so we decided that maybe this environment, it's not safe for us.
Being a lesbian and being a people with albinism, hey, it's nowadays, I'm so confused. Mm. Yeah, I'm so scared, you know what I mean? Yeah, I'm afraid to work everywhere. To go and everywhere, I'm afraid, because people take us like animals. You know me, animals.
It's actually crucial in Malawi when you get to be who you are, and then there's family and there's church. I will tell you my personal experience. I once got banned from it's a Christian organization that we're actually dealing with, teaching about the good news. But then, for the fact that they knew about me, they actually made me quit. It was even volunteer. It was volunteer work that made me quit, which is very sad. And you always get this comment, even in church, because in church, they know about me. So every time I get in church, people are afraid of me, people are afraid to approach me. They're even afraid of me sitting next to their kids because they think I will inflict this on their kids. When it comes to family, it's a huge challenge. They don't accept this. From where I'm coming from, I'm the only boy in my family, and there's so much expected from me.
She just told me that, you know what? If God made you a girl, that means you're supposed to be with a man. And then she just stormed out. It was hard because I've always wanted to work with, you know, an organization that actually fights for the rights of the LGBTI community. And when I found that opportunity, I wanted to keep it.
My parents, yeah, they know that I'm a lesbian, yeah? And only my mommy, eh, allow me.
In relation to LGBTI in Malawi and the law, there isn't a specific law that actually regulates, like talk about LGBTI. There's no provision where you not find anything in the law that talks about LGBTI. But then we have laws that criminalize same-sex. You know, we have laws that talk about unnatural offenses, like, and then we have sodomy laws that target people who are having sex, and men having sex with men. In terms of registration of any organization where people want to exercise their freedom of association, the law says everyone has the right under the constitution. It doesn't discriminate, it doesn't exclude anyone. There are no exceptions in terms of the law under the constitution. So the right to freedom of association is accorded to every person. So in that regard, it means it is also a right available to LGBTI. But it also creates an opportunity, because we know if the court makes those pronouncements, it builds up a momentum for challenging the criminal provisions in the penal code as well, because then we would have clear pronouncements on LGBTI rights.
So when we applied for registration, the Minister of Justice denied registration through the registrar's office with the reason that the activities of this community are criminal in nature. They are criminal under the laws of Malawi. So looking at the constitution, LGBT people have got even the right to, every citizen of Malawi have the right to freedom of association. So that's when we applied for judicial review to say the decision of the registrar general was biased. And there is no evidence that this community will break the law, because our objectives are just there to promote human rights. There's nothing criminal in our objectives. We had our first hearing in court, and the presiding judge said this is a constitutional review case, so it cannot be decided by a single judge, but it has to be decided by three judges. So we're just waiting for the next appointment when they are going to tell us the decision.
If they get to understand this award, the whole concept about this award, the attention that NRA is going to bring towards Malawi or even internationally, it's going to bring that change and the awareness to people that, you know what, actually people like this and they actually exist and people actually will learn from it. So it's going to be something huge. It is huge already by the whole concept, because it's going to liberate a lot of people who are like us, people who are gay Malawi.
Despite that they have differences or their beliefs, they'll recognize that actually they're these people. And some might actually understand, yeah. So I think it's a good thing. And it might actually help the government to maybe let us live free and marry who we want to marry at the end of the day.
I think it is important to be visible. It is important to love yourself. Because if you don't love yourself, no one is going to love you. So that is what we are also doing. We are trying to encourage people to be visible, to love themselves, to eliminate the spirit of self-hate, because people hate themselves just because they do not understand themselves. And we're trying to fight with that, that people should be visible and should love themselves. We are entitled to do it. If we don't do it, who's going to do it?